Starting the opening with Grandpa's Sweater Oatmeal Stout. A regular favorite of mine. This is one that I discovered early on in the craft beer, not really a renaissance, the craft beer movement, I guess, in Winnipeg. And it's one that I keep going back to. It's very nice. All right, let's get into the packages. This one says DIY converter board. That's not entirely intuitive. Couple of pieces. Oh, okay. These are more surface mount to dip converters. All right. Good for experimenting and prototyping. And this time I actually did get 8-pin in two different surface mount sizes. And then there's this one, which is for just 2-pin surface mount devices to go out to dip. It looks like you can put 8 of them on there. That you can use for LEDs or resistors or capacitors or any other surface mount component if you want to prototype with them. 20 pieces, SOP8, SO8, SOIC8, TSSOP8, etc., etc., 2 dip adapter, PCB DIY converter. These cost me a whopping $1.84 Canadian with free shipping. And they are actually 8-pin, not like the other ones that I ordered wrong the last time. And from the same seller, 10 pieces SMD SMT components, 0805, 0603, 0402, 2 dip adapter, PCB board, etc. This was only $1.64 for these ones. Again, a pretty good deal. I mean, there's not much to them. Obviously, they're going to be cheap. Next in, this one just calls itself electronic components. They are getting more and more vague by the day. Not that they were ever very precise. Ooh, LEDs. I seem to order a lot of different LEDs. I'm assuming that these are different than some of the other ones. They just look like normal clear lensed LEDs of the 5mm variety. Those are not visible to the naked eye. So they're probably some sort of ultraviolet or infrared. Can you tell what color they are? It's kind of hard to tell because the camera's going to be doing weird artificial things anyway. But I suppose we should check the listing to find out what they really are. 50 pieces, 5mm, 850 nanometer IR infrared launch emission tube, diode LED lamp emitting. I still don't understand why they call LEDs tubes. I'm sure it's a weird Chinese translation thing. Anyway, these came from Survey 2014. I bought from that seller lots and lots of times in the past. $2.36 Canadian with almost the same amount in shipping. Wow. But I have to assume that that was the cheapest available at the time that I bought them. As always, if you're buying any of these things, follow the link, yeah, but use the title for search terms and sort by lowest price to your location. Very little to say about them. 850 nanometer wavelength, viewing angle 90 degrees, 50 pieces.
All right, what's the next excitement? Ooh, this one's got some weight to it. It doesn't say what it is, though. Not even the standard lies for custom. Okay. Oh, multiple pieces. Woo! It's 4 kits. Well, that's excellent. I wonder if we can tell quickly what they are without spending too much time on it. This one's got a 7-segment LED, a couple of transistors, and a chip in it. The chip is a CD4511, which, if I am not mistaken, is just a binary decoder LED driver. I assume it's more of a demonstration of the abilities of that chip than anything else, which is always fun. Good to experiment and learn. Next in, what is this one? It has a couple of chips. Three chips and a couple of LEDs. So we have 4 push buttons, 4 LEDs, 4, what are those, flip-flops? Latches? No, they're flip-flops, I think. So I think what this is the classic game show or precedence, who's on first kind of circuit. Basically, if I am reading it correctly, these 4 buttons are your contestants. Whoever's running the quiz pushes the reset button, and then whoever answers the question first pushes a button, and their light lights up to show that they are the ones that pushed the button first. At least I'm pretty sure what's that one is. That should be a fun one to put together, and might even be practical. What is next? This one has some inductors and capacitors, and it calls itself mini power DC in 5 to 24 volts, and then a bunch of outputs. Okay, so it's a multi-voltage power supply kind of kit. And the fourth one, it's got this long skinny strip of a PCB, a bunch of LEDs along one side, a couple capacitors there. Does it say what it is on the board? No, just the brand name. Okay, so there's what it looks like built up. It's got a handful of chips on there. That doesn't tell me anything unless you happen to read Chinese. I don't, of course. Look at a USB, LED, micro USB, bunch of resistors, a diode. What are the ICs? LM358, op amps, which could also be acting as comparators. Yeah, got a bunch of LM358s. Okay.
DIY LED PCB digital display LED logic pin electronic kit high and low level test circuit soldering practice board kit. $11 with $1.51 shipping. Wow. This is a horrendous translation, much worse than usual. When the in is low, between 0.4, then this all happens and it displays an L for low logic level. When there's a high logic level, it displays an H. Oh, okay. So this is just basically a logic probe. Just a single input logic probe. Next in, we have four-person responder DIY kit. Four-channel answering, teaching, practice, welding PCB, blah, blah, blah. So that is kind of what I thought it was. This one costs $2.52, again, with $1.51 shipping. But I think they combined shipping from what I can see in my order history. So that's kind of cool. Anyway, yeah, it is what I thought it is. It's a four-person answering device, mainly composed of a four answering switch, a rushing latch circuit, an encoding circuit, and a seven-segment decoding display circuit. Okay, so basically after you reset it, whoever pushes their button first, their LED lights up and it locks everybody else out. Just like all your best game shows. The third one, 5 to 24 volts, 2, plus 12, minus 12, plus 5, minus 5, and plus 3.3 DIY power supply module. Linear regulator multiple output power kit. Oh, linear regulators? That looks an awful lot like switching regulators, really, doesn't it? With all those inductors in there? Oh, we'll have to find out when we dig into it. Anyway, that was the most expensive one so far. $6.61 and $2.33 shipping. Wow. Oh no, there are some linear regulators in there. Okay. So maybe the inductors are... Yeah, they're probably just generating the negative voltage. That's likely what they're doing. Okay. That'd be nice, having some nice smooth linear regulated outputs at various different voltages. Always a handy thing to have around the shop. And the fourth one in the package, USB audio spectrum lamp LED kit, car volume, LED indicator, music, audio display. It's not going to be a spectrum lamp, I don't think. I think it's just going to be a volume lamp. LED, yeah, volume indicator light, sure. It's not a spectrum, it doesn't separate the frequencies, it's just giving you the volume or the level of your audio, which is still really handy. Oh, it looks like it's got a little microphone on it too, okay. The louder the sound, the more LEDs light up from the bottom. Yeah, that should be a fun one to play with as well.
All right, what is this guy? Oh, it came from a Canadian reshipping warehouse. So I don't even get to guess based on the line. Ooh, giant LEDs. Oh, awesome. And these look like they're bigger than those 8mm ones I got last time, which means they're probably 10mm. Yep, that's what they are, nominally 10mm anyways, 9.6, 9.7mm. And in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 different colors. 8, 2, 4, 6, 7 different colors. There's what diffused white looks like, which I would call a cool white. Fairly standard LED blue. Okay. Yeah, that's definitely a warm white. Okay. Well, that's a neat little assortment. Let's go and see how much I paid for those.
10 millimeter LED diffused red, yellow, blue, green, white, orange, warm white LED diodes. I chose the 10 pieces of each color for a total of 70 pieces. Looks like I could have also got individuals in larger quantities. Okay. These cost me, that's pricey, $18.82. On the other hand, how often do you see 10 millimeter LEDs? I thought these were just too cool to pass up. 10 millimeter, there's the various colors. Beam angle 160 to 180, voltage 2 to 2.2 for red and yellow and orange, 3 to 3.4 for blue, green, white, 20 milliamps. That's all fairly standard. There's the wavelengths of the colors and the color temperature of the two different whites. Right.
And the last thing in, I hope it's a good one. I always like to save the best for last, but I don't always know what I'm going to get. It looks like a couple more kits. Wow. Spoiled for riches with kits. Are these the same or are they different? They look like they're different. Okay. Now this one's got a battery holder. What else we got in here? EQ kit branded. They supply a lot of these cheap Chinese kits. YFM-2. We have an inductor. Some switches. Y1 crystal, a couple capacitors, channel plus and minus, volume plus and minus switch, jack over there, and a chip on the back, which is obviously doing all the heavy lifting. That's interesting. What is the jack? That looks like a 3.5 millimeter. Okay. This other one's also got a 3.5 millimeter. It's got a microphone that I can see. It has several inductors. Is this like a Mr. Microphone circuit, maybe? Normally, you don't see audio and inductors together unless it's like a radio circuit. And it even calls it an RF02FM. So is that a little transmitter? Is that a receiver to go with it? Did it channel up and channel down? Sure. That's probably what that is.
Yep, that's what it is, all right. 8 to 108 megahertz DIY FM radio transmitter and receiver module. Frequency modulation stereo, probably not. Receiving PCB circuit board. Got the two of them for the princely sum of $2.63 with almost exactly the same amount in shipping. So, $5.50 for two kits, that's still pretty damn good. And there's what they're supposed to look like built up. Why does that one have zip ties on? Oh, right, it's got the battery box on the back, but sure. This one takes a voltage input, okay. Oh, good, there's the circuits. This is the transmitter starting at the microphone. That's microphone preamp. There is your input if you want to transmit from an external source. It is a stereo jack, but it sums it down to mono immediately. Amplify, we have a tuned RF circuit here. Okay, we have a couple of inductors over here in the output, a little RF filter, and then out to the antenna. And then there is the receiver. So again, yeah, it's just going to be an FM receiver chip that does everything. There's the volume up and down buttons. There's the frequency reference, 30.768 kilohertz crystal. We have the channel up and down tuning buttons. 3-volt battery, or 2 1.5 volts, and 3 inductors and a couple of capacitors. Oh, it actually is a stereo receiver. Would you look at that? Well, that's pretty slick. That's going to be a fun pair of kits to put together.
Wow. That, I think, is the most kits I've received in one mailbag. That's, what, 6 kits to build? Well, I guess technically 2 of them are sort of a pair, but whatever. That's going to be fun. And hey, how about this? Let's vote down in the comments which kit you want me to build first. It's not going to be next week. It'll probably be next month. But Yeah, vote down in the comments out of these six kits which one you want me to build first. Or if there's one from a previous mailbag that you'd prefer to see, go back through the mailbags and vote on one of those as well if you want. What else? Kits, LEDs. Some big, ridiculous LEDs, and I love that. And then these infrared LEDs, which I think I want to experiment with a camera module and just see if I can create a pseudo night vision kind of a camera. That could be fun to play with. And then there's these two dip adapters, which are just handy to have for tinkering. Thanks for watching, everybody. I do appreciate it, as always. Thanks to my Patreon supporters and my YouTube channel members and any other donors for helping me buy this stuff. And, of course, helping me buy a beer for me now and again. I appreciate that, guys. Questions or comments, or vote on which kit you want me to build next. Anything else you want to talk about, down in the comments, as usual. I'll talk to you later.